of magnitude up, then today we start the exercise 2.1. In last video already we have studied the elementary transformation. There are total 6 elementary transformation. 3 are for column operation and 3 are for row operation. Then using the elementary transformation, how to solve the example depending on this. Also we have solved this some example in last video, that is when we study the elementary transformation. Then we use the elementary transformation here for solving this example. Then in the given example, that is exercise 2.1, whatever it is required, we have to do this elementary transformation only. Okay. Then the given example is that here first apply the given elementary transformation on each of the following matrices and find the equivalent matrices. Okay. Then in the first example, we are given the matrix A as 1, 0, minus 1, 3. And what is the elementary transformation is given? That is the interchanging of row, means first elementary transformation. Interchanging row or column, okay? Here, we have to interchange the row. Then this R1 is changed by R2 and R2 is changed by R1. Just interchange of row. Then we have to get the new matrix which is equivalent to this A matrix. Then we get this R1 ki jagah kya hoge, R2 ke element, that this has R1 row and this has R2 row. So R1 ki jagah R2 ke element hoge, that means minus 1, 3 and 1, 0. Okay. This is our new matrix, just interchange the row. The second one example is given, that means the B matrix is given and it is required, that is R1, element of R1 is changed. But this element of R1 change, that is R1 minus R2. Okay, the change is here, changes for the element of R1. Then this R2 element remain as it is. This has R1 row, this has R2 row. When we do the elementary transformation, we write the row or the column which is unchanged. Okay, we write the row or column first which is unchanged. Then first we write this R2 row, because it is unchanged, we write as it is. Then the new matrix B is equivalent, that is the new matrix is equivalent to B, and what we get this as, that it changes for R1 row and this R2 row remain as it is. Then the element of R2 is 2, 5, 4, okay, as it is element. And this R1 element is changed, but this R1 element changed to, means this 1 is changed, R1 minus R2, that is 1 minus 2. 1 minus 2, that is minus 1. Then this minus 1, minus 5. Next element, this minus 1 is changed to minus 1, minus 5, that is minus 6. And this next element, 3 is changed, that is 3 ki jagah kya hoga, 3 minus 4, that means minus 1. Then the new elements are minus 1, that is 1 ki jagah, minus 1, minus 1 ki jagah, minus 6. And this 3 ki jagah kya hoga, minus 1. This is a new matrix which is equivalent to the original matrix, that is B. Then for the third one example, it is given for this matrix C1 changed to C2, C2 changed to C1. This column is interchanged, okay? Interchanging these two columns. And the, for this next matrix B is also given, for that row is interchanged. And we have to, what we have to do, what do you observe? Means when we interchange for column for the A matrix and row for the B matrix, then what is the change? We have to observe this in the A matrix and B matrix. Okay. Then this A matrix, when we interchange this column, then we get the new matrix is equivalent, means here rows are interchanged. Then what we get? Row is here in the first, the column are interchanged. C1 is changed by C2 and C2 is changed by C1. This is our first column, this is our second column. So C1 ki jagah kya hoga, C2 ki element, means 4, 3. And C2 ki jagah kya hoga, C1 ki element, means 5, 5, 1. And then next, here B matrix. Here in the B matrix, what we have to do? The row is interchanged. These are R1 row, these are R2 row. Then R1 changes to R2, R2 changes to R1. So R1 ki jagah kya hoga, R2 ki element, matlab 4, 5, and R2 ki jagah kya hoga, R1 ki element, matlab 3, 1. These are new matrix. And if we observe, whatever thing we get the new matrix, a new matrix after interchanging the column and here interchanging the row, these two matrix are equal. Okay? But we have observed, that is this A matrix and B matrix, after interchanging row and column, whatever we get the new matrix are equal. Okay? Then we get these two matrix are equal, means new matrix are equal. Okay? That is new matrix, whatever we get the new matrix, they are equal. New matrix are equal. Then fourth one example, here the given matrix, we have to do the column operation 2 times C2, and for the B matrix we have to do the row operation minus 3 times R1. Yaha pe C2 column ko 2 se multiply karte hain, and yaha pe R1 row ko minus 3 se multiply karte hain. ठीक है. देन हियर दिस आर आर1 रो, दिस आर आर2 रो, इज ऑन सी1 कॉलम, सी2 कॉलम, सी3 कॉलम. यहां पे भी क्या है, ये दिस आर आर1 रो, ये दिस आर आर2 रो, दिस आर सी1 कॉलम, दिस आर सी2 कॉलम, दिस आर सी3 कॉलम. ओके. एंड देन फाइंड द एडिशन ऑफ टू न्यू मैट्रिसेस, दैट इज आफ्टर मल्टीप्लाइंग दिस सी2 कॉलम बाय 2 वी गेट न्यू मैट्रिक्स व्हिच इज इक्वल टू ए. देन हियर multiplying this R1 row by -3 again we get new matrix which is equal to B. This will get here one new matrix, here also one new matrix, and then we have to take the addition of these two new matrices. Okay. Then we do the column operation here, means we get the new matrix is equal to B, equal to A, as multiply this C2 1 by 2 से multiply करेंगे. तो C1 as it is, we write the column which remain as it is first, 1 0, that is C1 remain as it is, C3 also remain as it is, मतलब -1 3. Changes occur for C2 column. तो C2 को 2 से multiply करना है, 4 and 1. Okay, this is a new matrix. And for this, the changes for R1 row, R2 row remain as it is. Then we write the R2 row first, which is unchanged. Then this has 2, this are 4, this are 5. Then changes only for R1 row. So R1 ko multiply karna -3 se, -3, 0, and this has -6. Okay. Then after that, find the addition of two new matrices. So A or B matrix ki addition find out karna. Okay. Then we take the addition, adding these two matrix A and B. Then what we get, the new matrix, which is the A plus B is equal to, take the addition component wise, that is we have studied in algebraic property addition of two matrices, we do the component wise. And here when addition is possible, when the order of A matrix and B matrix both are equal, and see what is the order, number of rows are here R1, R2, number of column are here C1, C2, C3, matlab two number of column and three, two number of row and three number of column, and the order is row into column, matlab 2 into 3. Then here also R1 row, this has R2 row, this has C1 column, C2 column, C3 column. Then number of rows are here 2, column are 3, that means 2 into 3. Then order is something, then addition is possible. Then we take the addition. Then do the addition component wise, that is 1 minus 3, 1 plus minus 3. Next element 4 plus 0. Next element minus 1 plus minus 6. Okay. Then next 0 plus 2, next element 0 plus 2, 1 plus 4, 1 plus 4, next is 3 plus 5, 3 plus 5. Then what we get, the new matrix which is equal to the A plus B. Okay, the new matrix is 1 minus 3 minus 2. These are minus 2. Next 4 plus 0, 4. Next minus 1 minus 7, that is addition, minus 1 minus 6, addition is minus 7. Then next here 0 plus 2, that is 2. Next 1 plus 4, 5. Then 3 plus 5, that is 8, which is our new matrix, which is equal to the addition. A plus, that is a, here we get A plus B is equal to the new matrix as minus 2, 4, minus 7, 2, 5, 8. And is our order, same thing as the order of A and B matrix, that is 2 by 3 is the order. Then the next one example is that the given matrix is A is 3x3 matrix. This is 3x3 matrix. And what we do the elemental transformation as here 3 times R3. And next elemental transformation is that C3 plus 2 times C2. That is first elemental transformation is on row and second elemental transformation is on column. Then this is our first row R1, this is our second row R2, and this is our third row. The first column, second column, third column. Then first elemental transformation is on R3 row, then first row, then first we write first and second row as it is. That is changes occur only on the R3 row. Then we write this R1 and R2 row as it is, means 1, minus 1, 3, second row 2, 1, 0. Then this R3 changes to, the changes for R3 row, this R3 changes to 3 times R3. Okay, then what we get, this element of R3, that is multiply all this element of R3 by 3. Then 3 se multiply karenge, toh 3 into 3, 9. Then this 3 into 3, 9. And this 3 into 1, 3. That is the element of R3 change. Okay. Then, and then what we have to do, the next is the column transformation, means this C3 plus 2 times C2, means we add the scalar multiple of the C2 column into C3 3 column, where changes occur for which column? C3 column. Okay. Then this C3 column is changed to C3 plus 2 times C2, which we have studied in elementary transformation third operation. That is adding the scalar multiple of all the elements or any row into this another. That is adding the scalar multiple of row into second row, or the adding the scalar multiple of column into the next column. Okay. Then which we have studied in the elementary transformation. Then adding the C3 2 times C2 with C3, then this element of C3 change, then this C1 and this C2 remain as it is. Okay, here C1 and this C2 remain as it is, and then only the element of C3 change. Here we have to do this operation, then after we get whatever the matrix in that this second operation. Okay, means after doing this 3 times R3 we get this new matrix, then again in this new matrix the next column operation. Okay, not the original matrix, the next column operation is only is for the new matrix. Okay, this one, then this matrix again change to this A is equivalent to the column which are unchanged. Write down this column as it is, C1 and C2 column, that means 1 2 9 as it is. C2 is -1 1 9, and the change is for C3 column. The C3 change to first element of C3, this 3 change to C3 plus, means 3 plus 2 times C2, C2 ka element ka hai? -1, means 2 times -1, that means 1. This 3 change to 1, first element 1, the second element, this 0 change to C3, means 0 plus 2 times C2, matlab 1, that is 2. The 0 change to 2, and the next last element, this 3 change to again, this 3 change to C3, matlab 3 plus 2 times C2, C2 ka hai? 9, that is 2 times 9, matlab 9 into 2, 18 plus 3, 21. This is our new matrix. Okay, in this way we get this new matrix. Then for the next one example, same matrix is given and these operations are interchanged. Matlab yahan pe humne row operation first kiya and baad mein column operation kiya. Yahan bhi kya karna hai, first column operation and baad mein row operation. Same operation, same column operation, same row operation, just order is changed. Okay, then here first we have to do the column operation. So the new matrix is equivalent to the A, and this column operation is for which column? C3 column. Okay, then C3 column change to C3 plus 2 times C2. First we do the row operation, and after that what you conclude from this example 5 and example 6 we decide. Okay, then first we do this column operation, then this C3 column goes inside this one, then this has C1 column, C2 column, C3 column, this has R1 row, R2 row, and this has R3 row. Okay, then C3 column change, matlab C1, C2 p value as it is. So first we write this 1 2 3, jiski value unchanged hai, we first write this column. Then C3 change, the C3 ki value ka change hoti hai, this 3 change to C3, matlab 3 plus 2 times C1 ka hai, -1. Then this has 3 plus -2, that is 1. Then this next element is 1. Then this 0 change to C3 plus, matlab 0 plus 2 times 1, matlab kya hai? 2. Okay. Then this has 2, 0 change to 2. And this 1 change to C3 plus, matlab 1 plus 2 times 3, that is 7. Okay. Then this has 7. After doing the column operation, we get this as new matrix. And after that, we have to do the row operation on the third row, that is this R3 change. Here, this third row, this has R1 row, this has R2 row, this has R3 row. Then this R3 row, we change 3 times R3. The new matrix ka hai, therefore, our new matrix is, then changes for third row, the R1, R2 is remain as it is. Then first we write down this as it is. Means R1 ki value kya hai? 1, minus 1, 1. Then R2 ki kya hai? 2, 1, 2. And third row ko kya? Then multiply this third row by 3. 3 se multiply karenge. Each element of this R3 row. So 3 into 3 kya hoga? 9. The next is also 9. And 3 into 7 kya hai? 21. And then we observe our example number 5 and the example number 6. Then what we conclude from this? That is, in this first example, we do the first row operation, then column operation. And then what we get the final matrix as? This one. And here also first we do the column operation and then row operation. Then what we get the final matrix as? This one. Then both are equal. That means their transformations are commutative. Means A plus B, their transformation, what we conclude? The transformation are, this transformation are quantity. This transformation of commutative matlab a plus b is equal to b plus a for commutativity of addition and for commutativity of multiplication ab is equal to b. Okay, that is means the transformations are commutative. Then the seventh example is that use suitable transformation on this matrix. Cuboid matrix is given here to convert it into an upper triangular matrix. When we study the basic of all the matrices, at that time we have studied all the definition, that is type of matrix, in that upper triangular, low triangular, identity matrix, all these types of different matrices. The upper triangular matrix matlab kya hai first? The upper triangular matrix matlab diagonal ke below element zero, the all the element below the diagonal is zero. Either it is 2x2 matrix, 3x3 matrix, that means it must be a first square matrix and after that diagonal, okay, and then below the element of diagonal is zero, then it is upper triangular, or we get a triangle shape in the upper portion. Then here, which is a 2x2 matrix, then we have a diagonal concept. This has a diagonal and this has a next diagonal. Then first diagonal ko below the element, below the first diagonal, we want zero. Okay, then yahan bhi hame zero karna hai. To kaun se row pe shuru karna hai? Second row ka first element. Okay, then see here our given matrix. We consider, suppose this has our A matrix. This has 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we have to make the changes in which row? R2 row ke first element mein change hona hai. Theek hai? Then we do the change in the second row. This R2 row is changed. Then what this R2 row is changed, we have to make the changes in the R2 row. Then the R2 row is changed. That means to get here, we want the upper triangular form or the upper triangular matrix. According to the type of upper triangular matrix, the diagonal element, that is the element below the diagonal, is 0. So first diagonal element is 1. So here we क्या चाहिए? 0. We want here in the place of 3 as 0. When we get here 0, या फिर 0 कब होगा? 3 की जगह 0 चाहिए, तो ये 0 कब होगा? That means if we get here 3 minus 3 का element होगा, then this has a 0. Okay, when here 3 minus 3 होगा, then it is a 0. But when we get 3 minus 3, for that we do the row operation. या R2 से R1 के element subtract करने, लेकिन R1 में क्या है? 1 है. When we do the row operation 3 minus 1 or R2 minus R1, then 3 minus 1 2 रहेगा. Okay, here when we do the row operation R2 minus R1, then 3 minus 1 we get 2, but we want 0. Then for that we have to multiply this R1 row by 3 and then take a subtraction. Okay, then this R2 change to R2 minus 3 times R1. If we multiply this R1 by 3, then what we get here? 3, and then this 3 minus 3 is 0. Then we multiply this R1 row by 3 and then we subtract this from R2. Okay, then what we get the new matrix as? This has first R1 ke element as it is a, R2 ke element change okay. So first we write the unchanged row as it is, then element for R2 change. Then what this 3 change to R2 minus R2 ka element hai 3 minus 3 time R1 ka kya hai 1, matlab 0. Here 3 ki jagah kya hoga? 0. Then second element change to 4 change to R2, 4 minus 2 times 3 times R1 ka element, matlab 3 times 2, then 4 minus 6 is minus 2. The next element is minus 2, and then we get here the upper side as a triangular shape, or the element below the diagonal is 0, then this is a upper triangular matrix. The next question is that convert this 2x2 matrix into an identity matrix by using the suitable row transformation. Okay, then here it is particularly given we have to use the suitable row transformation, not the column transformation. In the last one example, it is given use suitable transformation on this matrix to convert it into an upper triangular. Yahan pe hum row transformation bhi use kar sakte hain ya column bhi. It is not particularly given. Okay, which transformation you have to use? You can use column transformation also or row transformation also, any one of these. But if example is like this, means here it is given use a suitable row transformation, particular function you apply karna, okay? Then or sometimes it is given apply using the suitable column transformation. Then at that time you have to use column transformation. Then here you have to convert it into identity by using the suitable row transformation. Identity matrix matlab kya hai first? That is the matrix is of order either that it is must be a square matrix first, then 2 by 2, 3 by 3, 4 by 4, 5 by 5, okay, anyone. Then identity matrix matlab the diagonal is 1 and the remaining non-diagonal element kya hote hai? 0 hote, okay. Then this as our identity matrix 0, 1, okay. 2 by 2 ka identity matrix kya hai? This as, matlab 2 by 2. Or if you take this 3 by 3 identity matrix, then it is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Matlab identity matrix, that is the matrix in which the diagonal values are 1, 1 and the all non-diagonal elements are 0, then it is known as identity matrix or unit matrix. Okay. Then here we have to apply the suitable row transformation. Then how do this convert this matrix? Consider this given matrix as 1, minus 1, 2, 3. Then we have to convert this matrix into 2 into identity. Matlab kya hai? यहाँ पे क्या चाहिए? In order to convert this is also 2 by 2 matrix. This matrix को हमें this type में convert करना है. तो 1 below this 1, first make here 1. If it is not, first element is not 1, then first we have to make the first element as 1. Okay. But here already is 1. Then next we want here 0. The next operation क्या होगा? That is first make here identity. After that make the this element as 0. Here we have to make here 0. Then after making here 0, next is here we have to make identity. यहाँ पे क्या चाहिए? Identity मतलब 1. यहाँ पे 1 convert करना है. और बाद में हमें यहाँ पे 0 convert करना है. ठीक है? यहाँ पे क्या convert करना है? 0. Okay? Then the operation is in which order? First make here identity. After that here make 0. After that here identity. And then this upper element as 0 element. Okay? Then the order of the operation is this one identity. Then 0. Then identity. And then this 0. Then we do this same thing order. Then the given matrix is this one. Then we want here identity is already. If there is identity element, then we keep this element as it is. If not identity, then we have to make it as identity. Then here already is 1. Then we want here 0. यहाँ पे 0 चाहिए. तो क्या है row operation apply करेंगे last. यहाँ पे भी हमने row operation apply किया था. यहाँ पे 3 था. तो we convert this 3 into 0. For that we do the row operation क्या किया? R2 minus 3 times R1 से subtract किया. Okay? That is R2 minus 3 times R1. Then we get here 0. Then same thing यहाँ पे क्या चाहिए? 0 चाहिए. यहाँ पे क्या है? 2 है. Then R2 minus क्या होगा? This R2 change to R2 minus 2 times R1. तो R1 का क्या? 2 से multiply करेंगे. This R2 से subtract करेंगे. तो यहाँ पे क्या होगा? 2 minus 2. Then we get 0. This R2 के element क्या change हो गए? R2 minus 2 times R1 means we do the row operation on this R2 row. क्या row operation है? R2 minus 2 times R1. Then this R2 elements get changed. And this R1 remain as it is. Then we first write the elements of R1 as it is. R1 की element क्या है? 1 minus 1, okay, as it is. And the element of R2 change, मतलब क्या change होगे? 2 minus, this 2 change to, 2 change होगा, या 2 minus, R2 minus 2 times R1, then 2 times 1, मतलब क्या? 0, 2 की जगह क्या होगा? 0. और second element, this 3 change to, क्या है? R2 minus 3 minus 2 times this R1, मतलब minus 1, then 3 minus minus plus, तो क्या होगा? 5. Then यहाँ पे 5. Then first identity already दिया, then we make here 0. Then next क्या करना? यहाँ पे identity चाहिए. Then when we get here 1, then for that we have to divide second row by 5. Okay. Then we get here 1. Then we divide this next row operation, that is we divide this R2 row by 5. Or either we write this as 1 by 5 times R2. R2 row को क्या करेंगे? 1 by 5 से multiply करेंगे. Then this new matrix is equivalent to A is 1 minus 1, 0. यहाँ पे 5 को 1 by 5 save, R2 row को multiply करेंगे. तो 0 into 1 by 5, 0. And 5 into 1 by 5 क्या होगा? 1. Okay. Then first identity, then 0 and then 1. Then we have to make here 0. तो यहाँ पे 0 कब होगा? When we take here minus 1, अगर यहाँ पे plus 1 आ जाएगा, तो minus 1 plus 1 क्या होगा? 0 होगा. ठीक है. Then for that, we have to do the row operation. If we take the addition R1 plus R2, कौन सा element change कर रहे हैं? R1 का change कर रहे हैं. तो R1 change होगा. R1 change to R1 plus R2. Then R1 का element change हो गए. Then this new matrix is equal to, then this R2 rows remain as it is, we write this as it is, and this R1 changes to 1 plus 0, R1 element plus R2 element, that is 1. Then R1 element plus R2 element, minus 1 plus 1, 1 plus 0. And this is our identity matrix is of order 2 by 2. Then we get this as a new identity matrix. In this way, we do the row operation or column operation. But in this exercise 2.1, whatever the given operations, given elementary transformation, we have to do this for solving an example. Then, thank you for watching this video. Like, share, subscribe, and comment this channel.